Hello, hello again, everyone. This is Jan from New York City, and my channel name is Jan from New York City Saves Money. Hey, how's everybody doing on this bright and beautiful Saturday morning? Hope that this audio clip finds everybody doing well. You know, I mentioned that I'm going to do a weekend chat, and I'm keeping my promise. I'll be on camera tomorrow on Sunday for a weekend chat. But for today, I decided to upload an audio clip talking about frugal ways to stay healthy. You know, I love Dr. Phil McGraw. We're all familiar with him by now. He's a very well-known doctor. He has his own show. And you've seen him on TV many, many years. There was something that he had said years ago, and I never forgot it. And it's in the area of common sense. And I love this statement. I never forgot it. He said one day to a guest, "There's nothing common about sense." You know what? Those words are so true, I never, ever forgot it. And that's what we're kind of sort of talking about today. But first, let me begin this by prefacing, I am not a doctor, I am not giving out medical advice. I'm just sharing with you from my own personal experience what seems to work for me in a frugal manner to stay healthy, to feel good. Now, there are certain things that we do that can encourage, let's say, bad health habits. And there are certain things that we could do in a common sense manner that could really, you know, improve our health habits. You know what I'm trying to say? Now, this is a tiny thing, and I swear by this product, you would think that I had stock in the company. I'm talking about hydrogen peroxide, good old hydrogen peroxide. Do you ever notice that if you ever have a cold, okay, a really, really bad cold, and, you know, sometimes you forget yourself and you just rinse out, let's say, your common, ordinary toothbrush. You rinse it, but maybe you're missing one component of rinsing. Do yourself a huge favor and not only rinse your toothbrush thoroughly in the first place, rinse, 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 clean it off, but rinse it with a capful of hydrogen peroxide. You could put that in a paper disposable cup, a little bit of hydrogen peroxide, turn your toothbrush upside down, and let it sit there for about at least about 30 seconds to one full minute. And the purpose of that is hydrogen peroxide acts as an anti-infective, okay? So it is thoroughly cleaning the germs, residual germs, from your mouth that you thought you cleaned off your toothbrush, but you didn't. Now, why am I bringing this up? How many times did this ever happen to you or somebody you might know that had a cold, okay? And maybe, let's say, a little bit of a sore throat. They were seemingly getting better, or so they thought. But guess what? They possibly might have reinfected themselves again by using a toothbrush that still had residual germs on it. Okay. So the bottom line on the cheap is clean your toothbrush with hydrogen peroxide rinse. It really, really is an excellent, excellent idea. Okay. That's one area. Now, here's another thing that I have noticed in my life that definitely seems to cut down on, let's say, sharing a cold with somebody that you're living with. Listen, it doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure this one out too. I enjoy having two separate mugs. If you're living with two people, have your own separate coffee mug. Meaning, for example, suppose you're like coffee lovers in your home. All right, I'm just saying. Now, as it turns out, the best idea is to have your own unique mug that is your own, okay? Not to be shared by anyone else. You really will have drastically cut down your risk. I'm very, very funny that way. Once I had a visitor here about 3 or 4 weeks back, and they were ready to grab my cup. You should have heard me. I said, "No, don't touch that. I am a fuss budget. I like having my own cup. It's just the thing with me. I just like keep the cup separate," because we don't know if that person, coming down with a cold, they have, don't have any apparent symptoms yet or whatever. But the bottom line is, You are reducing, in my opinion, and I am not a doctor or a pharmacist, but in my opinion, through my life experience, I have found it's just a really neat idea. If everybody in your own family had your own unique cup that you know is your own, then I'm telling you, everybody responsible, every man or woman for themselves, responsible for keeping their own cup clean. Keep your cups and glasses separately. Now, I know that sounds crazy, but it's actually not. It's actually not. And it's a very frugal way. It's a very frugal way to help prevent certain things. Just saying, in my experience, okay? So don't take this down as word written in stone. This is my life experience. Take it as you would, but I'd love to share. Now, the next thing, okay, mental health. Okay, again, I'm not a psychotherapist or anything, but it doesn't take a genius to figure out that if there's someone in your life that adds value to your life, that's the person, and you enjoy being around, and you feel great around them, and you're comfortable and secure, doesn't it make a whole bunch of sense to be around positive, uplifting people? Conversely, does it also make sense that if there's someone that for some reason constantly contributes nothing but toxicity in your life, do you really, really need that? This is only a question you can answer. So while we can't avoid the world, well, we are part of the world, and all of us idealistically wish to get along, right? Hopefully. But we can reduce our time amongst negative people. I mean, people, and listen, everybody gets the blues now and then, and we all try to help each other out. But if you know someone that is like just really like rude to you or disrespectful to you or doesn't even consider that your time is just as valuable as theirs. You know, it's really a shame when some people think that their time is more valuable than yours. And I'm really adamant about that. Everybody's time is equally important to everyone. Therefore, in my honest opinion, people should respect that. But since people don't always do the right thing, you have to evaluate the choices that you make. Keep in mind, we live in a world of choices. You can make the better choice, or you can make, well, not the greatest choice. Just saying. Next, eating regular meals at regular time. Now, again, not a doctor, but doesn't it go to show? Don't you feel a little weird if you've not eaten, let's say, two meals in a row? Okay, you can't do that. That's just not a great idea for you physically. And there are just so many reasons for that, including blood sugar levels for anyone. So, you know, eat properly. Doesn't mean you have to eat hugely, but be sure to have regular meals at regular times. Next, sleep. Now, this is something that I even have to work on because many, many times people might find me up late and they might find me up super early. And somewhere in between the lateness and the crack of dawn, I might catch a nap. I have to work on sleeping a little bit more. You know, I miss the olden days when I was a young person and, used to go to bed with Mr. Moonlight, wake up with Mrs. Sunshine. Doesn't work like that necessarily as you get older. But in fact, you actually need a little bit less sleep as you get older. But you should have, all of us should have, an adequate amount of rest. Because even if you, let's say, skip a night of sleep, normal sleep, doesn't really affect you at first. But you will notice the ill effects of it. You'll feel lousy if you do that, like, on more than one occasion. So truly, don't snub sleep. You need to sleep. Sometimes it's hard to shut off the world from around you. You know, with the noises from the street, or you really rather watch that late night TV show, or boy, why did they play your favorite movies at 2 o'clock in the morning, type thing. But I know there's a lot of competition out there to keep us awake. But really and truly, you have to prioritize yourself and get some sleep. And last but not least, don't forget exercise and having fun. and just like putting the world's problems to the side, do yourself a favor. Don't watch the news constantly. Being around that negative information all the time, it's just not a good thing. And you know what? Many times I have learned this as I'm older. The world has a funny way of taking care of itself. So for a short time every day, tell yourself this. You cannot fix the whole world, but you can at least try to control your world, the one that you live in, the one that you want to be healthy in. And in the meantime, this has been Jan from New York City. Thank you so much for listening. Why? Because I really do appreciate whose time? Your time. Have a wonderful day today. Enjoy your Saturday. I'm going to end this with a little bit of music. Have a great day, everybody. And I'll be back on camera tomorrow with the Weekend Chat. Have a great day.